Today we're going to take a look at a very old Excel function. It's the ancestor of XLOOKUP, the lookup function. So some time ago I made a video called 10 Functions for Engineers, and one of the functions used a crazy version of the lookup function to find the node in the hierarchy, so to find the parent. So there were a lot of comments in that video, people wanting to understand how that function worked. This is that video. But first, let me introduce you to the simplest version of the lookup function, and then we're going to work our way up. The lookup function is actually super simple in terms of the arguments that you need for it. So here I have a list of employees and their salary. I need to figure out the bonus that applies to each employee based on their salary. And here's my guidance. So if an employee earns between $30,000 to $50,000, they should get 5%. If they earn more than $100,000, they should get 15%. So we're going to start off with lookup. The first argument we need is the lookup value, where we're looking for their salary. That's going to tell us their bonus percentage. That's our value right here. Next is the lookup vector. Where are we looking this up? We are looking it up in here. And I'm planning to copy my formula down, so I'm going to make sure that I fix this using the F4 key so my referencing doesn't shift. Then I need the result vector, and that's right here. I'm going to use F4 to fix that as well. So notice there is no more argument to define if I want an exact match or an approximate match. What the lookup function does, if it doesn't find an exact match, is that it is going to give you an approximate match. So here for Kim, I get 10%. Is that correct? Kim earns between 60 to 100 and I get 10%. That's correct. Let's just drag this down and see what we get. Here for Anne, we get 15%. That's correct as well. Now, the reason this works correctly is because my salary column is sorted in ascending order. If it's not, you can get wrong results. So basically what the lookup function does is that it expects this to be sorted in ascending order. It goes and looks for 89,500. If it doesn't find it on this list, it's going to give you the largest number that is smaller than what you're looking for. So the largest number here that's smaller than what we're looking for is 60,000. That's why we end up with a 10%. And it works because our salary column is sorted in ascending order. So now I want you to tell me why this one that I'm going to write right now is not going to work. Okay, so you have to pay attention.
Attention!
This time, we need to find the ID for each employee. We have the name of the employees here, and their ID is sitting in the K column. Now, the great thing about lookup is because we can specify a separate return range to our lookup range, it doesn't matter if that range is on the left or the right side of our table, which is great. So to get the ID, I'm going to start off with lookup. My lookup value is the name of the employee. My lookup vector is right here. I'm going to fix it using F4. And my return vector or result vector is the employee ID. I'm going to fix it with F4. Close bracket, press enter. I get ID 16 for Kim West. That's not correct. Send this down and just see what we get. We get 14 and 16, but they're assigned to the wrong people. So there is a problem here. Can you figure out what that is? The problem is that my lookup vector isn't sorted in ascending order. So I'm looking up names from this column here. I have to make sure that the column I'm looking things up is sorted in ascending order. Otherwise, lookup is going to give me wrong results. So I'm just going to select this, right mouse click, sort A to Z, and now we end up with the correct results. Let's just double check. Kim West should be ID 13. That's correct. Karina Smith should be 16, and that's correct. So keep that in mind whenever you use the lookup function. Your lookup vector needs to be sorted in ascending order. Now let's take a look at an advanced lookup situation. So here I have different BOM levels and part numbers. I want to find the immediate parent part. So for example, the parent of this one is 0, the part number that I should get in front of this in this row is going to be this one right here. The part number for these is going to be this one. The part number that sits in front of this one is going to be this one here because this is the parent of this one. Now, what's important here is that we always want the immediate parent. So the parent of these is this, is number two, but the parent of these is not this number two, it's only this one, right? So we're always looking at the last match. How could we solve this with our traditional lookup function? Well, let's think this through. When I'm at the zero level, there should be nothing because there's no parent here. When I'm at this level, then I need something, I need this one. So I'm actually going to start writing the formula here. Once we've figured out the right function, then I'm going to copy it up as well. So we're going to start off with lookup, the lookup value. Well, we are going to look for the parent of this, which is going to be this minus one. And what about my lookup vector? Well, I just want to look at the immediate parent. So I could probably do something like this, where I fix the beginning of my reference and I let the end be variable. So as I drag this down, my range expands, right? Because I don't want to highlight everything. I don't want to find the future part numbers because I need the ones from the immediate parent, the one that's right above me. So I'll go with the lookup vector as this and the result vector, well, that's going to be the same range. And in the same format, I'm going to fix the beginning and leave the end variable, right? So when I close the bracket and I press enter, in this case, it's correct. So I've just enabled conditional formatting so that we can easily track if everything is working. Now, when I drag this down, this part is correct as well. This is correct too, but here I end up with problems. Why is this problem happening? This is the number I have here for two. And what do I need to see? I need to see this two and not that two, because this is the immediate parent of all of these. Now, the reason this is happening, and you might have guessed it, is that this part, the lookup vector, isn't sorted in ascending order. And I can't sort this in ascending order because it doesn't make sense in this case. A way around this is to create our own lookup vector that consists of either zeros or ones, or errors or ones, because that way we're not going to have that ascending problem. Let me show you what I mean. So instead of looking up for this number here, I'm going to bring that as a check. We're going to bring it to our lookup vector and create a vector that checks whether this value minus one equals our parent. So let me show you what we get in this case. If I highlight this and press F9, we're going to get true and false. So it means that the first one is the parent, the second one isn't, which is great. But now how do we use this as a proper vector? We could convert our false values to errors and our true values to ones. And remember, in Excel, false and trues can be easily converted to numbers by doing a mathematical operation on these. And I could do one divided by this here. Now check this out. When I highlight this and press F9, we get one and error. If my lookup vector only consists of ones and errors, this ascending problem is not a problem anymore. All I need to do for my lookup value is to look for a number that's greater than one, and it can be any number as long as it's greater than one, because what's going to happen is this. Everything is going to work properly. Now, we can just double check here just to make sure that we understand how this part works. If I'm on this cell down here, I'm going to press F9 so you can see the result that we get. We end up with errors and a bunch of ones, right? Because whenever we get a two, we get a match. Now, because the lookup function returns the largest number that's smaller than our lookup value, it's going to end up giving us the last match, which is exactly what we need to solve this problem. Now, let's also account for whenever we have zero. In this case, we are going to end up with an error. So I'm just going to use the if error function in case our result is an error. We're just going to return a dash. Now let's just send this down so we are consistent. Now, with the introduction of the XLOOKUP function in Office 365 and Office 2021, these type of lookups have become so much easier to do because you don't have to use these type of tricks. So I'm going to go to this cell, just like we did before, and start with my lookup function. The lookup value is more logical to set up, just like you would, the way you would think this through. We're going to go with this minus 1. This is going to give us the node for the parent. Then the lookup array, just going to select what we had before. We're going to expand this. So I'm going to fix the beginning and keep the end variable. The return array is the same. Let's fix the beginning and keep the end variable. Now, we can already deal with the situation if we don't find something. So if we get an error, we are going to go with a dash. And the match mode, we do want to look for an exact match. So I'm going to go with 0. And now this is the part that is going to make everything easier. We have the ability to search last to first. This is going to give us the last match. That's it. I'm going to close this, press enter, and I get the exact same results as using this crazy lookup function. Now let's just copy this up as well to make sure we are consistent. Okay, so that wraps up our lecture on Excel's lookup function. Do you use this function in your files? Let me know in the comments. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give this video a thumbs up. Subscribe if you aren't subscribed yet. And I'm going to see you in the next video.